consider subscribing. Don't forget to press the bell icon. It's only the way you'll be updated when I upload a new video. Thank you so much for coming back to this channel. Thank you so much for support so far. The returning subscriber, thank you so much. I appreciate it. For the new subscriber, please consider subscribing to this channel. Consider supporting this channel. It's the only way that you'll be notified when we upload a new video. Remember, we are still talking about the new UAE law that will come into effect in February 2022. And we are trying to break down the small segments that will be very important in the new law. And these small segments, you clearly need to understand such that you know what entitlements you have in one way or the other. In today's video, we are going to look at what does the law talk about holiday pay, deductions, passports, overtime, and overtime exemption. Let us try to look at that. What does the law say about the employees, the holiday pay, the sick leave, and the study leave? Those are four different scenarios. So we are going to look at which of these four scenarios, such that you can clearly understand where are my benefits coming from, what am I entitled to as the employee of this company that is employing me. So this is exactly what we want us to know and discuss. I'll just go straight into what the small segments written in the law. What is the law say about these four different instances or the different scenarios? One, employees will be required to take their holiday in the year it falls due. Meaning that if you have your vacation or you have your day and your vacation is supposed to be June, it is mandatory you take your vacation. However, still it is unclear for those people that will not be willing to take their vacation on that same month or some date, what will be the repercussion or what will be the decision taken. Remember, most of us or most of the people, normally after completing a given number of years of contract, let's say for example 2 years, let's say for example you're completing 2 years in June, and someone will be like, I'm not willing to go for my vacation in June. I want to go to December because it's when I'll celebrate with my family. But remember, the new law says that if you are supposed to take your vacation every after 2 years and your 2 years fall in that same date of June, it is the same date that you're supposed to take your vacation. No any other addition of any month whatsoever. Then in scenario two, what does the law talk about holiday pay? It says payment in lieu of holiday pay on the termination of employment is to be calculated using what we call the basic pay. For the holiday pay, your amount of money will be calculated using what we call the basic pay. And if you are terminated from your contract or you're terminated from your job, you will still have to be paid your holiday that are not paid in advance. So you will still have to take all your money. But remember, all this will be calculated using what we call the basic pay in advance. Still, let us look at another scenario. That is study leave. Remember, the law says that employees with more than 2 years service may be entitled to a 10-day working days or study leave. So if you've completed 2 years with that company and you're willing to take on an induction course or you're willing to take on another course somewhere, that is at your own expense, the company will entitle you to 10 days working days of study leave that will be paid still with full salary. That is how it is amazing. Let us look at another scenario which talks about the sick pay. Remember, most of us or most of people have gotten sick even during the period of the probation period. In some Gulf countries, the probation period is 6 months. To other countries, the probation period is 3 months. For example, right now, I think the probation period in Dubai or UAE is just reduced to 3 months. In countries like Qatar, in countries like Saudi Arabia, the probation period is 6 months. What will happen if you get sick in that probation period? We are now relating that to the new law, which is coming into effect in February 2020. Will you be paid money or you will not be paid money? That is where we need to understand clearly. And this is exactly that we need to keep in mind. What does the law talk about getting sick or the sick pay during the probation period? Let's read. Let me read to you what the law says. Sick pay during probation period. Employees will not be entitled to any paid sick leave during their probation period. Meaning that if you get sick during the probation period, you will not be entitled to any salary or whatsoever. I think that is very clear. Thank you so much for guys for tuning into this channel. Thank you so much for watching videos to this channel. Support this channel by tuning in, subscribing, give them the thumbs up, share. This video, put a very important, put a comment in the subscription. I'll always be more than happy to get back to you as we try to break down and look at other small segments and other scenarios that are being captured in the new UAE labor law that is coming into effect 2022. Thank you so much. See you again. It's Max from the Max Creation team.